Let's start with the topic. So like I mentioned, we're talking about five effective and powerful habits to work on your English communication skills. So let's start with the first one. Now, the first technique is a very conventional technique, which everybody has been telling you since day one, even if you were in school, even if you were in college, or even today. सबसे कॉमन चीज होता है जो आपको बताया जाता है, इफ यू वांट टू वर्क ऑन योर इंग्लिश डू दिस, कैन एनीवन गेस समथिंग? इट्स वेरी कॉमन, सबसे पहला यही चीज आपको बताया जाता है. कैन एनीवन गेस? अन्या, डू यू हैव अ गेस? लाइक द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट पीपल टेल यू, लाइक यू नो व्हेन यू आर सपोज्ड टू लाइक वर्क ऑन योर कम्युनिकेशन, वर्क ऑन एनी लैंग्वेज. रीडिंग. ओके, सो बेसिकली No matter what language you're learning or no matter where you're starting from, the very first thing that people tell you is reading, right? But I'm going to tell you that we need to do the same thing in an effective manner. आपको बोला जाता है to read newspapers, right? Stop reading newspapers. Okay, Ananya, I know you look shocked, right? You look shocked. Stop reading newspapers. It's actually टू नेगेटिव. कितना नेगेटिविटी है दुनिया में ऑलरेडी, हमको क्यों चाहिए नेगेटिविटी, राइट? स्टॉप रीडिंग न्यूज पेपर, देर बोरिंग, देर अनइंटरेस्टिंग, एंड आफ्टर अ कपल ऑफ डेज यू नो यू विल सी ऑटोमेटिकली आपका इंटरेस्ट खत्म हो जाता है पढ़ने में. स्टॉप रीडिंग न्यूज पेपर. सो व्हाट आई वांट टू रीड? ओके, सो फर्स्ट आई वुड सजेस्ट फाइंड योर नीश, लाइक व्हाट आर यू इंटरेस्टेड इन. Are you interested in fashion? Are you interested in, you know, reviews? Are you interested in stories? Anything what are you interested in? Read blogs about it. Read articles about it. And how are we going to do that? Read aloud. So every day you read for 10 minutes and you read aloud. What I mean by reading aloud? Zor se padhna hai. Bahut sare learners come and tell, we read madam, we read every day. Man mein padh raha hai na, to kya hota hai? Humko lagta hai ki we know this word. A lot of times, I think a lot of our, you know, members, like audience would also agree कि जब आप पढ़ते हैं मन में आपको लगता है आपको सारे words आ रहे हैं, but ऐसा है नहीं. When you actually pronounce them, when you actually, you know, start talking, you'll come to know that you do not know the pronunciation or you're not saying it right. Immediately नहीं आता है. So we need to first, you know, practice by reading aloud every day. Har roz 10 minute kuch bhi interesting cheeze padho, please. Don't read newspapers, like I said, it's really negative, really boring. Read something interesting. Read short stories, read blogs, read comics. I would say read comics. I love comics. You can read comics, okay? And read them aloud for 10 minutes at least every day. Are we clear with this?
I think everybody is. And we even got a suggestion here about movie scripts. Translating movie scripts, but I think even you can read movie scripts. They're available online and you can just go for your favorite movie. And I think when you're playing the character which you love, you're going to love saying it out loud as well. So that would be something.
Exactly. You could actually play the parts of those characters, you know, just like the real characters did. So yeah, that's a great, you know, suggestion. Thanks. So can we move to the second pointer quickly? Can we move to the second habit?
Sure, I think let's move to the second. The first one was very clear.
All right. So now the second one is not a just a habit. I would say it's a very, very effective technique. Okay. So for example, if you are having a conversation, now this is specifically with respect to one-on-one communication. Jab aap one-on-one conversations kar rahe, to look more like a proficient speaker, to look like you have good communication skills, I would recommend this paraphrase. ठीक है, ये वर्ड सुना आपने पहले? Paraphrase. So exactly क्या करना है? ठीक है? So let's just say let's do an example. Ananya, I want to ask you, how were your 10th standard board exams?
I'm supposed to answer this question. How were my board exams?
Yes.
They were pretty boring and I wish I had not given them.
Okay. Do you want to tell anything more about it? Like, how was the experience? Anything more?
It was a new experience because 10th is the very first standard where we give our board examination. And I was pretty nervous as well because this was the very first time we were giving an exam out of our school, and it was also a new experience for I think every student who gives their class 10th board examination.
Okay. So, Ananya, you want to say that it was a novel and a nervous experience because it was the first time that you were going to attempt something of this, that stage, that complexity. But at the same time, I think it must have been thrilling, right?
Yeah, it was.
Now, guys, if you must have seen, what did I do here? I repeated the same thing that Ananya mentioned. All I did is I cut it short and I rephrased it. In a way, but I'm telling Ananya that I paid attention to you. ठीक है? मैंने क्या किया? जो उन्होंने बोला, मैंने वही चीज़ repeat की, बल्कि उसके साथ साथ मैंने उनको मेरा understanding भी add किया उसमें, और उनसे उससे उनको क्या पता चला कि मैं उनकी तरफ ध्यान दे रही थी, and while I'm doing that, I am also showing understanding that I am also trying to relate to it. So this is one very, very effective technique, So when you're talking to people one-on-one, not just informal, but also formal situations. Let's just say your boss or your colleague is allotting you tasks ya kuch task pe clarity de raha hai. To aap bol sakte hai, okay, so do you think, so you mean to say A, B, C, and aapka usme inputs daliye, and then you can say, so this is what you mean. So what happens is when you do that, again it shows that you are attentive. At the same time, you're actually thinking about it. You're not just hearing and letting it go. So this is a very, very good habit, and people would actually like talking to you. What do you think, Ananya? Like, how did you feel when I paraphrased the whole thing for you?
I think I felt pretty good because most of the people around me, they have this one problem ki the samne wala person is not listening. And when you paraphrase, it kind of shows that, okay, whatever I said, they actually listened, and it shows because whatever I said, they just made a small point and repeated it. So I think paraphrasing is pretty good. It's something that I am going to start doing now, even in the formal as well as informal setting, because I think even when somebody asks me what are the work pipeline for the day, and they tell me ki acha this is all we have to do, and if I repeat that, they're going to be happy at the fact that I listen to them. So that's also one way to impress the boss.
Absolutely, Ananya. Okay, so let's dive to the third habit, which is on the similar lines. Okay, so again, Ananya, I'm going to ask you a question. I'm very curious. I'm very curious about you, Ananya. I hope you don't mind that.
I don't. Please ask away.
Okay. So, Ananya, I want to know your favorite color. Which is your favorite color, Ananya?
Black.
Okay. So, and why do you like it?
I think I like black because it goes with everything. When I wear black, I know I can pair it with any other color. It's going to complement well with any other color, and it also makes you look slim.
Okay. That was too long of a sentence, Ananya. All right. Now let's just say I want to communicate the same thing that Ananya mentioned to someone else. Okay. So let's just say I am having a conversation with another friend of ours, where that friend asks me, what is Ananya's favorite color? Okay, now there are two ways to say that. The first way is, Ananya said, my favorite color is black, and I like black because it goes with any, you can pair it up with anything. It makes you look slim. Okay, this is what Ananya said. This was one way. Now, what the second way is, Ananya mentioned that her favorite color was black, and that she preferred wearing it because it made her look slim and she could pair it up with anything. Okay, okay. What is the difference, guys? Can anyone point out what is the difference? Can anyone from the audience can point out what was the difference? The first statement I said, Ananya mentioned that I like black because it's a nice color and it can be paired with any outfit, any color. And it makes me look slim. And the second way was, Ananya mentioned her favorite color was black because she could pair it with anything and that made her look slim. What is the difference? What sounds better? What sounds better? Ananya, you just tell me what sounds better.
I think the second one, because the first one was like a copy-paste thing. But I preferred the second one because it kind of changed the sentence beautifully.
Okay. Do we have anyone from the audience telling, what do you guys think? Like, which one would you prefer better? Which one would you like more? The first one or the second one? I want to know why.
Come on, guys. We have 19 people watching. So let's get active. This session is going to be pretty amazing. Okay, Afreen says and Pooja says the second one is better. The second one is good. So we three are in the same spot.
Exactly. Now, why is the second one better? Zubair also mentions the same. Good choice, guys. Good choice. So the second one is better because here we are speaking in indirect speech. Okay? Direct speech is when you copy paste the same statement and, you know, deliver it in the same manner how it was told to you. And indirect speech is when you are mentioning the statement how you would say it. Okay, so always now what there's this one habit, you know, I've seen a lot of people do when they're narrating instances. Jab wo kuch aisa instances ya kuch events batate hai, toh fir wo kaise bolte hai pata hai? I've seen a lot of people do it. Fir maine usko bola ki mujhe nahi aana. Fir usne bola kyun nahi aana? Okay. और फिर उसने बोला कि मैंने तो ऑलरेडी प्लान कर लिया है. सो नाउ दिस सिचुएशन व्हाट हैपेंस इज व्हेन यू आर एक्सप्लेनिंग और नरेटिंग एनी इंसिडेंट इट गेट्स टू ड्रैगी. मतलब हमको है क्यूरियोसिटी, हमको जानना है कि क्या हो रहा है सिचुएशन में, लेकिन इतना भी क्यूरियोसिटी नहीं कि पूरा डायलॉग टू डायलॉग हमें याद रहे कि ओके फिर आपने ये टोन में बोला, फिर उन्होंने ये टोन में बोला, एंड देन इट गेट्स टू ड्रैगी. रादर देन दैट यू कैन कीप इट शॉर्ट बाय सेइंग this is what I said I would be interested and I wouldn't be interested, whereas he mentioned that he has already planned to go for the event. Simple. So here you sound like a smarter speaker. At the same time aapki jo aadat hai na zyada time lene ka baat karne ka wo kam ho jayega and it will be more effective. People would really really want to listen to you, would want to talk to you rather than
like,
you know,
having the board.
Okay, are we clear with that? So always try to speak in indirect speech where you are not just copy pasting or quoting dialogues. Interpret them in your way. Okay, this is what was told, or just that way. Okay, so for example, what was the difference? I would repeat the example again. So another second one, like black, the second one, the second one was where Ananya mentioned that she liked black because it made her look slimmer. Got it? So here you are putting your inputs, you are putting your brain. Clear with this?
Yes. Guys, do answer coach. She's asking you a question. And I think the replies are a bit delayed because even the last time when you asked the question, we got a lot of responses after we had already moved on. So I think they're going to agree with you.
That's okay. That's completely okay. Let's move to the next point. Okay. Now, this is a habit. And it's a very interesting habit. I would say if you know, lately a lot of people I see around me are super active. Okay, aap mein se bhi bahut sare log internet pe bahut zyada active honge, and you know, you must be engaging in a lot of other extracurricular activities jahan pe aap social media pe zyada post karte, right? So keeping on the same lines, aap reels banate hain, aap shayad you know videos banate hain. तो वैसे ही यू गॉट अ मेक और यू नो यू गॉट अ ऑडियो और वीडियो जर्नी. ठीक है, सो व्हेन आई से स्टार्ट ऑडियो और वीडियो जर्नलिंग, इनिशियली यू नो ट्रेडिशनली पीपल वर सजेस्टेड दैट स्टार्ट राइटिंग अ डायरी. ठीक है, आई वुड अगेन मेंशन दैट इट इज अ गुड हैबिट इफ यू वांट टू वर्क ऑन योर इंग्लिश कम्युनिकेशन. स्टार्ट राइटिंग अ डायरी, कूल. बट अगेन व्हाट आई वुड से इज डू नॉट मेंशन योर डेली एक्टिविटीज or anything about your personal life. We don't need to keep a proof of our stupidity in a book. Yeah, where it can be found by others. And then people can, you know, go through it. And then people will be witnesses of the stupidity that we did. So, rather, if you're going to write a diary, I would say pick topics. Let's just say today you watched a movie, talk about the movie. If you did something new, if you went for shopping, write about that. If you, you know, randomly have thoughts about, you know, doing something for the world, you want to change something, write about it. So that is how you will write a diary. Please do not write about your personal, you know, lives.
So basically anything and everything, right?
Yeah, just pick out topics. But when I meant audio or video journaling, ye hamara, you know, habit hai, the fourth habit. What do I mean by audio or video journaling? So you are maintaining a diary, but in an audio or a video form. Okay, so what you do is, you can talk about anything. You record yourself while you're talking. It can be just the voice recording or it can be the video recording. I would suggest initially, if you're starting to learn English, start with audio recording so that you can focus on, you know, the words, the sentence construction, the pronunciation, how well are you able to, you know, maintain the flow of words. Then, you know, gradually, matlab, phir aap aram aram se move to video journaling. Jahan pe aapko lagta hai, okay, now you are well versed with sentence construction. And now you want to focus more on how you are being seen. Aap baat karte waqt kaise dikhte hai. You want to work on personality aspects, you want to work on behavioral aspects. Tab jaake aap video journaling start kar sakte hai. So, ye video journaling or audio journaling kya hai? Are we clear with that? We are just, you know, randomly talking about things. Like today, let's just say I have had this live with Ananya and I think it was a great experience. So I'm going to just talk about it that, you know, today we had a new member join in and this is how the live went. This is how interesting it was. There were so many people. These were the people who talked about it. So again, I'm just, you know, mentioning about an event. I'm narrating an event, but I'm recording it. The same thing you will do in a video recording. The only difference is you're going to focus more on the behavioral aspects. Like, okay, how are you seen while you talk? Do you use your gestures? Do you work on your expressions? How is it? How do you look when you talk? And this is, you know, slowly, gradually going to improve. So you get to keep a track also. Aap dekh sakte ho ki day one pe aapka performance kaisa tha? And let's say day 10 or day 20 or day 30 pe aapka matlab performance kaisa tha. And it doesn't have to be long. It doesn't have to be long. It can just be a minute long. Okay? Are we clear with that?
Alright, I think we are. And even in the comment section, everybody is agreeing with you. And I think we were even asked a question which was regarding the previous point. Which was from the question was is indirect speech the right way to talk? That's the question.
Is indirect speech, again, you know, there is no right or wrong way. I would say there is a way and there is a better way, or there is a more effective way. So I would say indirect speech would be, you know, more effective when it comes to communication. Especially when you're doing formal communication, indirect speech is something that has to be, you know, followed.
But it's the other ways are not wrong, right? That's what you're saying.
Yes, they're not wrong. Again, you know, language is really flexible. It can be how you want it to be. But again, effective and not so effective, that's the bad. Okay?
I think that's now, about answering the question.
Coming back to our last pointer, the fifth habit. Again, it's not just a habit. I would say it's a technique. Okay, it's a very simple technique. It's as simple. It's so simple you can start using it right away. Okay, and I would say start using contractions. Okay, what are contractions? बहुत बहुत बड़ा word है contractions क्या है? Okay, so you know, verbs and not को जब हम club करते हैं verbs और नॉट देन वी क्लब इट तो वो कॉन्ट्रैक्शन बन जाता है. तो फॉर एग्जाम्पल डू प्लस नॉट बिकम्स डोंट. ओके मस्ट प्लस नॉट बिकम्स मस्टंट. शुड प्लस नॉट बिकम्स शुडंट. आर वी गेटिंग इट व्हाट कॉन्ट्रैक्शंस आर?
आई थिंक वी आर.
यस सो मेक श्योर दैट यू स्टार्ट यूजिंग कॉन्ट्रैक्शंस इन योर डे टू डे कम्युनिकेशन. ओके रादर देन सेइंग आई डू नॉट वांट टू पार्टिसिपेट आई डोंट वांट टू पार्टिसिपेट. ओके rather than saying I cannot be a part of it, I can't be a part of it. Okay, so this might seem like a very minute thing, itna zyada farak nahi lag raha, but actually if you start implementing it, you will see a lot of, you know, native speakers or people who are fluent in speaking, they do not use the broken, like they do not use both these words separately, they use contractions. So there's a long list of contractions you can just, you know, go through that. Just type contractions, grammar contractions on the internet, and you get a list.
Got an example. You are is equal to your.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. Okay, it's as simple as that. Use the right ones though. Okay, use when you're using them, make sure you're using the right ones. Are we clear? Okay, so far, if you understood things, I would want everyone to, you know, just show a thumbs up. Yeah, so that I know, okay, the learners have understood. And there is a bonus point coming. But before that bonus point, there is one more point because you've stayed for so long, right? And you guys are a regular, like, audience. And for you, I have a lot of love for you, which is why I have a bonus point, okay? But before that, how about you go back and follow AlphaBoard if you haven't? Now, again, 10 seconds. Ananya, count 10 seconds.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I think yes. The people here have.
Yes, they have. Like, I know, like, the ones who are regular, we don't even have to ask. So, that's okay. Cool. Coming back to our bonus point. Okay, now we're talking about communication skills, right? Now, there is always someone we want to start talking like, okay? So, you know, so there might be more than one people or one person that you want to, you know, speak like, or there must be certain style, certain dialogue. So, what I would say, choose or pick a role model like whom you want to talk, okay? So it can be a celebrity, it can be a speaker, someone from TED Talks also, a businessman, anybody, you know, any famous people that you think you want to talk like, you want your communication style to be like theirs. Just, you know, like select them as your role model. And how are you going to actually implement this role model thing? So what you could do is you can refer to their interviews, refer to their speech, refer to all the public live, you know, events there where they've been, where they've actually been interviewed, and how they respond to questions. So they have, like, everyone will have their unique style of, you know, talking. So of course, like I would say, do not become like the person completely, but there are definitely, you know, things that you would want to incorporate in your own speech, like that person. So you can start, you know, slowly picking on things. And like I said, you don't have to choose only one role model. It can be a lot of other people. Like, you can be 4 to 5 role models. So you can say, okay, my accent, I want my accent to be somewhat like this person. I want my command, I want my pitch, you know, to be as strong as this person. So for example, I love how calm and poised Madhuri Dixit is while she talks. But at the same time, if you see, Priyanka Chopra has a very strong, you know, very, very sharp pitch when she speaks. So so you can actually, you know, check what are the qualities that you want. So I'm giving examples because these are celebrities that everyone knows, okay? You can actually choose anybody. It can be someone from our country. It can be someone from any other country or industry altogether. If you have people that you know from your industry specifically, who could help you not just with communication but also with knowledge, which will boost your career also. Follow those people and see how they talk. What are the words that they use? How do they, you know, like their overall presence on screen, their overall presence when they're communicating. We can actually focus on all this and pick up small things and practice that, mimic that. Okay, so this is a very, very effective way. Most lines, you know, we do that with characters also, movie characters. You pick up personality traits, right? ये काफी cool है, तो उनसे आपको वो pick up करना है. So the same thing you can do with communication. All right? So these were the effective and powerful habits to actually improve your communication skills, your English communication skills specifically. I hope it was really useful. If you have any questions, please ask questions so we can quickly respond to everybody.
Come on guys, if you have any questions, just ask in the comment section below. Meanwhile, we have a few questions from the learners. So the first question, and I'm also taking it from the comment section as well. It is said that we talk both verbally and non-verbally. Through our gestures and everything. So what are the things that we should keep in mind while communicating non-verbally as well?
Okay, that's a great question. And we are going to do a separate segment, specifically, a separate chain for body language. So I would want everyone to be very attentive every time these, posts come up, reminders come up. I would want your participation that day. But for now, I think Ananya has raised a very nice, interesting question that, okay, it's not just verbal communication, it's non-verbal communication also. And what are the things that you need to keep, be mindful of? So someone in the comment section a couple of minutes back had mentioned gestures. Okay? So when you're talking, it's not just your mouth talking, it's your face talking, it's your hands talking. Even now you see, I'm using my hands a lot, okay? So, try to observe how you are seen while you talk. So, first of all, your expression should be matching with your message. And be happy, sound, or I wouldn't say happy, but look positive when you're talking to people. Imagine me coming to the live and saying the same things, but with a different face. Like, hi Ananya, I'm so excited to be here with you. Hi everybody, I'm so excited. How does it look?
It looks very, very sad and forced.
It is forced. Okay, so be mindful of, how a lot of times we are not even aware of, okay, what are the expressions that we make, because that's so natural, it's just so natural, it's coming from inside. But when it is an important situation, when you're in an interview or some important scenario, I would request everyone to be mindful of, okay, what are they portraying through their face as well. Be optimistic. Have a smile on your face. We've discussed this before as well, so I wouldn't stress a lot. And when you're talking about your hands, okay, now because we're on the live here and I can you can see me specifically only up from here to here. So talking about the gestures, I would say, do not overdo your gestures. Matlab, bahut zyada aap gestures use nahi kare. Let's just say if I'm talking to you and I'm constantly moving my hands. Okay, it's going to be distracting. It's going to be really distracting, and while I talk to you, you are not going to be listening to me. आप मेरे को सुन रहे हो? नहीं. You're actually, focusing on, okay, what's happening, what's happening. So make sure that you don't move a lot. You don't overdo your actions. At the same time, when I am like I said, don't overdo your actions. Also, don't be too rigid. Like if I don't move at all and I'm just communicating to the audience and to Ananya, like this, keeping a straight face without moving a lot, it will get boring. I am bored right now. I want to move. Okay? So I would say keep a balance. Use your gestures. Use the right gestures. Avoid anything that will be considered offensive or not suitable for the situation. Like snapping is something I've already mentioned. Pointing out to the audience. Do not point out to your audience like this. Don't do this. Got it? Don't do this. Okay, so there are a few things that you're not supposed to do if you have to point out to someone. I would say even while talking, even when I'm talking to you guys, this is how you point out. Okay, so yes, that was focused on not just the verbal part but also the non-verbal part. Any other question that we saw? I did see.
Wait, I did see one question. I think there was a question about passive voice. What is passive voice?
No, the question was what about passive voice? Like, how is it useful in
communication?
How is it useful probably in communication? Okay. So, guys, what I would say, again, passive voice helps a lot in written communication and formal communication. Okay? But when I'm talking, like, now what is the difference between active and passive voice? Active voices, I killed him. Passive voices, he was killed by me. Okay, so it's as simple as that. In the first statement, I'm giving more importance to the subject, that is I. And the second statement, I'm giving more importance to the object, that is him. So, you know, every time I cannot verbally, when I'm verbally communicating, I can't use passive voice. Food was eaten by me. Or the video was shot by me. The live was conducted by Ananya. So Ananya conducted live. So when you're talking, I would say it's better that you use active voice in formal communication when you're writing things, or when you want to emphasize more on the object, on the receiver, then you can use passive. So yeah, Ananya, do we have any more questions?
We have one more question. That's the last question we have. What are some communication blunders that we should not make?
What are the communication blunders that you should not make? We have a huge list of communication blunders. You know, more than do's, I would say always the list of don'ts will be longer, right? But one thing that I would stress on, no matter what, no matter whom you are talking to in communication skills, make sure that you make the other person that you're talking to or the people that you're talking to feel important. Feel like you are paying attention to them. If you are communicating with someone or you're interacting with someone and it looks like you're not actually paying attention to them, आप उनका बात नहीं सुन रहे हो और उनके जो भी स्टेटमेंट्स है उनको वैल्यू नहीं दी जा रही है, उनके प्रेजेंस को एक्नॉलेज नहीं किया जा रहा है. सो नो मैटर हाउ गुड ऑफ अ स्पीकर यू आर, इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू मेक द अदर पर्सन फील गुड एंड नो वन इज गोना वांट और नो वन विल एक्चुअली वांट टू टॉक टू यू. ठीक है, ये चीज आपको हर बार ध्यान देनी है. आप कैसे भी बात करते हो लेकिन आपको जिससे आप बात कर रहे हैं उनको आप इम्पोर्टेंस दो, उनको एक्नॉलेज करो, emphasize karo. Okay, if you ask something, okay, let's just say I'll give you an example. If I ask okay Ananya, I heard you had a bad day, what happened? Okay, and if Ananya says yeah this happened and you know I was actually finding this difficult so I was sad, and then I say okay you know what, I have something nice to tell you.
Ignoring my sadness.
Yes, I completely dismissed what she said. And I start talking about myself. So I would say this is also a bad habit. Always acknowledge other people and empathize with them. Like if she's mentioned from being sad, I have to be like, you know, that's really sad. And yeah, I hope, you know, you feel better, you get better. So yeah, guys, I think we're done with talking about this topic. And I think it was really effective. It was helpful. And I hope that you really liked it. Thank you so much for joining today. And for more such content, you have to follow AlphaGold. If you want to specifically learn English, you want to work on your communication skills, you can always, always DM us. You can always just share your phone number, your email address, and we'll definitely get back to you. And if you don't know, if you're unsure ki kya hoga, kya nahi hoga, so always know that you can take a free demo with us. You can take a free class with us and then decide for yourself whether you know what you want to do. Or in the free demo also, we analyze what your communication skills are. So you can get a feedback on what are the areas that you should be working on. So it's a nice platform. It's a nice opportunity. Free hai uske upar. Free cheezein kuch karna hai na. So just book a free demo. You can just drop in your contact details. Like DM us. We'll get back to you. All right. Thank you so much for joining.
Thank you so much, coach. Thank you so much, coach. And I hope that everybody who is here right now found this session to be really helpful, because I know I, for one, am taking a lot of things from the session that I'm going to implement in my real life too, especially paraphrasing. That's something that I'm going to do more often now. And as coach said, go follow Board Infinity and Alpha Board, because you're going to see content which is going to be relatable to your everyday life, and it is going to help you almost every day. The videos and the content that is posted is going to help you furnish your communication skills and everything else. So go follow us right now and stay connected with us while we come to you with fresh content on a daily basis. Thank you so much, coach.
Thank you, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Bye.